Let's check on European markets first. They are mostly in the green as investors shake off worries over the escalating tension in the Middle East after Iran launched an attack on Israel Sunday. The German DAX and the French CAC 40 are up 1% each, with industrial stocks leading gains. As for Wall Street, futures are also pointing to a positive open, with the major indices seen to rebound after a heavy sell-off last week. Goldman Sachs also boosting sentiment after it reported its profit jumped 28% in the first quarter, boosted by its investment banking unit.
Here are other stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of banking software company Temenos after an independent probe into allegations made by Hindenburg Research were found to be inaccurate and misleading. The short seller had accused Temenos of using aggressive accounting tactics to boost its share price. Shares of the Geneva-based firm surged 21% on the news. Also in focus, shares of Apple after a drop in iPhone shipments allowed rival Samsung to reclaim the top phone maker spot. Apple shares fell 1% in pre-market trading. And we're also keeping a close watch on shares of Tesla after a report said the EV maker will lay off more than 10% of its workforce, citing an internal memo. Tesla shares are down 0.7% before the bell.
Asian markets kicked off the week on a back foot amid the geopolitical tensions in the Middle East. Japan's Nikkei 225 shed 0.7%, while Australia's ASX 200 fell 0.5%. But the Shanghai Composite bucked the downswing after China's central bank kept its policy rates unchanged as expected. Here at home, Philippine shares extended their slump to an eighth straight session. The main index now at the 6,500 level after tumbling 1.5% Monday.
The market is currently in a corrective phase. 6% down, just 6% down though from the 7,000 level. However, with the backdrop of sticky inflation that we saw in the last 2 to 3 months and increasing global oil prices due to the renewed conflict in the Middle East, and more importantly, the next Fed meeting where it may possibly start to shift its policy is at least 2 months away.
Yeah.
So there's really no positive catalyst in sight.
Okay. As
we stand today. So I would expect in the meantime for market participants to once again remain cautious and remain on the sidelines.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. says he sees no reason for China to fabricate the alleged secret agreement between former President Rodrigo Duterte and Chinese President Xi Jinping on the West Philippine Sea. Marcos told reporters Beijing's insistence about the deal has convinced him of its existence. But the chief executive noted former Duterte officials have presented conflicting statements on the supposed agreement.
Why is there not one single document that contains that agreement? Why is there not one shred of evidence that can show that this agreement exists? Why, when we the transition period between the previous administration to this administration, did no one mention a secret agreement? Why was it kept secret? These are very simple questions. But I'm finding a great deal of difficulty finding answers for them.
Marcos also insisted Manila's recent trilateral agreement with Japan and the U.S. is not directed at anybody. He said a great part of the deal are the economic cooperations being fostered by the three countries.
We have to maintain commerce, we have to maintain the peace, we have to maintain stability. And that's what really the point of the trilateral agreement is so that we provide for ourselves in the region, in the Indo-Pacific region, an area of peace and stability so that we can all find our way in this new global economy, post-pandemic economy.